Hey everybody, Wes Murgard here with work remotely, liveremotely.com. Recently, I was able to spend some time exploring the South American country of Peru, and in today's video, I'll be sharing with you some of the best experiences from those travels. For those of you who don't know, Peru is located along South America's western coast. This video is going to focus on activities you can do in and around the Cusco area. Cusco is located in southeastern Peru. Cusco also serves as the best jumping off point to visit Machu Picchu and the Sacred Valley region. Speaking of Machu Picchu, that's our first stop in this video. No visit to Peru is complete without exploring the ancient Inca ruins of Machu Picchu. Machu Picchu is considered one of the modern wonders of the world, and after spending an afternoon exploring these ancient Inca ruins, I can definitely see why. Machu Picchu is Peru's most recognizable cultural site, and it serves as a beacon for tourism to Peru, which many locals also depend on to make a living. Most travelers will start their adventure to Machu Picchu from Cusco. You can also take popular hikes such as the Salkantay Trek or Inca Trail, which will originate from Cusco as well. During my trip, we did the Salkantay Trek, which involved 4 days of hiking through the beautiful Andes Mountains. On the fifth day of our adventures, we explored Machu Picchu before catching a train back to Cusco. If you don't have the endurance or time to reach Machu Picchu by foot, don't fear. You can take a scenic and relaxing train ride to Aguas Calientes instead. Look for the Moray station, which services Cusco, and that will be where you want to head out from. One thing to keep in mind when doing this option is you'll likely need to catch a 45-minute taxi ride to the station, so be sure to budget that time in there as well. And if you're looking for a really unique experience on your trip to Peru, you should definitely consider the Salkantay Trek. The Salkantay Trek is an immersive 5-day experience starting near the village of Soraypampa. I would highly recommend booking this adventure through alpaca expeditions. During this trek, you'll hike the Humantay Lake, cross the Salkantay Pass, camp under the stars at Yaktapaca, which is a campsite that overlooks Machu Picchu. You'll even make coffee from scratch at a local farm, and so much more. Be mindful that the Salkantay Trek is considered rigorous due to the length, elevation gain, and altitude. Much of your hiking will be done at over 10,000 feet, which is about 3,000 meters. The altitude means that you'll want to spend at least a couple days acclimating in a city like Cusco to avoid catching altitude sickness during your trek. Each day is going to involve about 8 to 10 miles or 14 to 16 kilometers of hiking. The highest point of the trek comes at Salkantay Pass, where you'll reach altitudes of over 15,000 feet, which is about 4,600 meters. Keep in mind that if you're going to Machu Picchu, you will need to pass through the town of Aguas Calientes. This is another place you'll want to check out when visiting Peru. The buses that take you up to the ruins depart from this beautiful mountain town. I will say there aren't actually many activities to do in Aguas Calientes itself. However, the city has a massive supply of restaurants and souvenir vendors to explore. Cutting down the side of Aguas Calientes, you'll find the beautiful Urubamba River. Many of the restaurants located along this side of town offer scenic dining options to take in views of the Urubamba. I would recommend spending a night in Aguas Calientes the evening before exploring Machu Picchu. Doing so allows you to catch the earliest shuttle buses to Machu Picchu the following morning. And so if exploring more ancient geological sites is your thing, consider visiting the Inca ruins of Pisac. Pisac is easily accessible from Cusco via car or bus and takes about 1 hour to reach. When we visited Peru, we booked a day tour through alpaca expeditions. That day tour took us to Pisac, Moray, and the Mara salt mines. We'll discover the other two destinations later, but combining all three stops makes for a perfect day trip itinerary from Cusco. If you're acclimating for one of the longer hikes, this is a great way to spend a day on the front end of your trip. The ruins of Pisac consist of numerous Inca buildings, stone ruins, farming terraces, and a large burial wall. One of Peru's more peculiar Inca ruins are those of Moray, which we also explored as part of our day trip with alpaca expedition. This site is thought to be half science experiment and half agricultural site. The different terraces resulted in different microclimates within the larger bowl, and thus the Incas were able to test the effects of different growing conditions on crops here. I'll keep this one short and sweet. Did I enjoy visiting and learning about Moray in person? Yes, I did. Is Moray a must-see? Maybe. If you have time or you're already planning to be in the area, definitely stop by Moray. If you're pressed for time, this is one I'd probably skip, especially if you're already visiting Pisac, Machu Picchu, and other Inca ruins. The third destination from that day trip with alpaca expeditions was the Mara salt mines. This is one of my favorite activities from our trip in Peru. This is despite the fact that I had no idea it existed before planning my trip to Peru. The beauty that is the Moray salt mines largely distracts from how genius its ancient design really is. Residing somewhere in the mountain above Moray is a very salty spring. The water that flows down from the mountain from the spring crosses through the salt pans. As the water collects, it will eventually be swept away by the high mountain sun, and left behind will be the deliciously famous pink salt of Peru. No visit to Moray is complete without tasting the salt, so be sure to purchase some from the locals during your visit here. My single favorite place that we visited in Peru had to be Humantay Lake. This is one of the most picturesque places I have ever visited. If you're undertaking the Salkantay Trek, then you're in luck, because the first day of hiking is going to include a detour to this beautiful laguna before venturing on to the Salkantay Pass itself. Otherwise, you're likely going to have to attempt this one, Humantay Lake, by chartering a day tour from Cusco to Soraypampa. From Soraypampa, you'll hike up to the lake. Most excursions to Humantay Lake from Cusco will leave in the very early morning hours, and we're talking like 3 or 4 a.m., since the drive is about 3 hours in each direction. Be sure to check with your individual tour operator, but don't be surprised if you're spending about 3 hours of hiking time round trip to reach and hang out at the lake. The hike to Humantay Lake is extremely steep, and it will take most people around 90 minutes on the way up. Altitude will be the main factor slowing you down, as the lake sits at nearly 14,000 feet. It's about 4,200 meters. If you're not interested in that much hiking, the locals of Cusco love telling you how to pronounce this next one. The Inca ruins of Sacsayhuaman, which are kind of loosely pronounced sexy woman, are located along one of the hilltops that surround Cusco. The ruins themselves are interesting, but what really sets this area apart is the fact that it overlooks the city of Cusco. After spending some time exploring the Inca ruins, the walking path dumps you off at an overlook that offers sweeping views of Cusco. If you're staying anywhere near Plaza De Armas, I would suggest taking the 30-minute walk up the hill to reach the ruins. The walk is fairly steep, especially when considering Cusco's elevation, so don't be afraid to take the cab if necessary. Cusco's cultural city center, the Plaza De Armas, is a must-see, and it also boasts a beautiful fountain in the main square. The square is surrounded by many restaurants, cafes, bars, and shopping. As a tourist strolling through the square, chances are some of the vendors and artists will pepper you with requests to book their tours and purchase their goods. These encounters will be very common around the main square, and to be honest, it can become quite annoying given their frequency. Even if you do end up purchasing souvenirs this way, it won't stop the requests for long, so hunker down and develop a thick skin for it. Once you get a block or two away from the actual square, it's much less of an issue. The area surrounding Plaza de Armas is a great place to find some of Cusco's best bars and restaurants. And this is very important for our next travel tip, which is to try an authentic Pisco Sour. Drinking a Pisco Sour is probably the most delicious way to experience Peruvian culture. The base alcohol in this drink is, not surprisingly, Pisco. Other ingredients include key lime juice, egg white, simple syrup, and a garnishing of bitters. The egg white gives the drink a thick and creamy texture that really sets it apart from the Chilean version. You go to France for wine, you go to Kentucky for bourbon, and you go to Peru for a Pisco Sour. Since returning to the USA, I've tried Pisco Sours at several restaurants, and they rarely live up to those concocted back in Peru. So enjoy them while you're there. Cusco has many iconic buildings, but there are perhaps none with more curb appeal than Iglesia de la Compañía de Jesús. I know it's a mouthful. The church sits along Cusco's main square, the Plaza de Armas. If you have time, be sure to stop inside the church and enjoy views of its stunning historical architecture. Construction on the church began in 1576, and the version we know today is the result of some reconstruction following an earthquake that damaged the building in 1650. Hands down, Iglesia de la Compañía de Jesús boasts the best curb appeal of any structure in Cusco. Now, I put together this guide for my trip to Peru, where Cusco served as the home base. Many of those activities require you to leave and spend time outside of Cusco itself. And no matter how much time you end up spending in Peru, make sure you set aside time for exploring Cusco itself. The city is rich in history and boasts many great museums, bars, restaurants, and other cultural sites past what we discussed here. If you found this video guide helpful, be sure to check out my Peru travel guide available on my website by following the link in the video description. Once again, I'm Wes Murgard with WorkRemotelyLiveRemotely.com. Don't forget to subscribe and check out some of our other channel content, and thanks for watching.